woman of the hour. Jeez, it took you long enough. Picked up an appetite just waiting.
Sit down, let me finish this. Then we can drop in on Señor Vector.
Mentioned something about a surprise yesterday. Am I remembering right, or just had a brain fart?
Probably both, because you usually forget shit. But it just so happens, I think I might have bagged us a sweet-ass J-O-B.
Go on.
I mean, maybe it's not as big as that, but... just that he's fronted by a little-known someone named Dexter Deshawn.
Only the top fixer in Night Fucking City. Fat-ass black Jesus of the afterlife. 300 pounds of partly gold-plated coupe.
I'm glad to.
Thought Dex bounced out of the ring a few years ago. Messed with a nasty crew in Pacifica. Things got ugly.
Mm-hmm. Gang wars 2 years back. Somehow Dex got caught up in the craziness. A lot of bodies lying in the streets by the time the shooting stopped. Yeah, Dex got lucky though. Managed to slip under the radar till tempers cooled. Took a while, but he's made one hell of a comeback.
Guy's up to his elbows in blood, Jack. Do you want to shake his hand? Work with him.
It's the biz, V. Everyone's got blood on their hands. You deal with it. You move on.
How did you manage to pull this? Trade in your spleen or something? As far as I know, we're not the type to get fingered by Dex.
You and me? Oh, but D-Buck, she's the one that hooked us up. Got us talking. Knew it was a done deal the moment he laid eyes on me. Come on. Ain't nobody who can resist this. Am I right?
Sure, Jack. Whatever you say. So what's the gig? We meant to come out in one piece?
Well, our savior wants to tell you everything himself. Face to face. No pressure, but... old deal's riding on you now, chica.
I'm glad to.
Why do I gotta go? You and T-Bug draw straws without me?
T-Bug and Dex go way back, and my face is yesterday's news. All Dex says he needs to check you. Talk to you. Look, V, it's his job, his rules. I can't blame him for taking a personal approach. And it ain't as bad as you think, okay? Trust me.
Guess I got no choice then.
Dex is a real deal when it comes to fixers. Don't get me wrong. Don't got nothing against the Padre or Wakako, but Dex is a leader of his own. That's what I'm saying.
Don't get me started on fixers. They catch a client, find the cheapest gonk to do the job, then drop their corpse at a landfill.
Shit. Hit the nail on the head, B. Gracias, Dios. Brought your wheels. Gave them to my guy yesterday to smooth over the dents after our, dust off with the scabs.
Thanks, Jack. Much appreciated.
Some top-notch work Miguel did. Rides like it looks. Factory new.
Damn it, I need more
we'll
time.
See about that.
I've got a lot going on.
Are we rolling or what?
Listen, if anything, you can take your shit back and force it on someone else.
Hello?
Let's feel this factory new ride.
base. Choose orbital area.
You tell me.
First stop. Ripper Doc. Anchika, easy on the gas, eh? I just ate. I was supposed to stop by Vic's anyhow. I got a date. Me and Miss D.
You don't say.
She's so sweet. Really gets me, you know?
Yes, I see what you mean. About the fucking driving.
You get used to it.
Oh my god, I just ran out of people.
What Dex has cooked up for us.
Huh?
But you are not the masters of your memories! For your eyes do not belong to you, or rather... not only...
Hey, V. Dr. Vector will see you now.
From way back.
Vicky, spry as ever, you old ripper. Good to see you.
Good to see you too, V. It's been a while. To what do I owe the pleasure today?
Last gig. Had to jack into a client's neuro socket. Think I might have gotten spiked.
Experiencing migraines, nausea, hypersensitivity to bright lights.
Oh, kit and caboodle.
All right, Kit. We'll sort you out in a flash. Besides that, how are things?
Met a new fixer. Gave me a job. Name's Dexter Deshawn.
Known quantity from the afterlife. No denying you're moving up.
But? Something you're not telling me, Vic?
Keep your guard up, that's all. I've heard some things about Dex. He's not as chill as he makes himself out to be.
Need some new kit, but tools, not toys, Vic. Time I bumped up my sights and got a grip.
Really? Now? Finally?
Vic, shit's getting real. Got a job from Dex Deshawn. Hitting the major leagues. Need tech that can perform.
The Dexter Deshawn? Well, that is something. But let me guess. Hasn't paid you yet.
Quit crying, Vic. I'll bring you the Eddies later, with interest. You know I will.
Last time, you hear? Chair, please. Sit down and relax. Kuroshi Optics. Best I've got, and should be about right under the circumstances. Now jack in.
Kuroshi, whoa! Vic, nothing tops that on the market.
Sounds like it could come in handy then.
I gave you my word I'd pay you back, but this... might be too rich for my blood.
We'll work something out. Right now, I'm just out to make sure you get back in one piece. Eddie's in hand. You peruse and choose while I scan. Let's see what's going on inside.
One, like I said. Decent enough scanner. Displays data on your cornea. Cherry on the top's a built-in external lens disruptor. In layman's terms, any surveillance cam will capture your face as a blur. But just remember, your body will still show up as crystal clear. This should do the trick. Talks to Kiroshi Tech, too.
I'm ready. Carve away.
Excellent. Let's do this. Lay that major league arm of yours right here.
So, what's new in the life of Victor Vector?
Yeah, if I'm being honest, not much. And that's fine with me. I used to live in a world where all that mattered was who's who, what's what, and how's why.
And what happened?
One day, I just dropped it and never looked back. I'll never be a legend in this town, but been sleeping nights ever since. Just like that. Thanks. Now, a bit of anesthetic and I can start cutting. Feel anything?
Play-by-play, though? Really, Doc? Makes you sound like a dentist. Always going on and on.
Don't be mean now. Remember, I'm old. I got a shaky Ganic hand. Could slip. Lights out for a minute, all right? Okay, let's test this. See the magic in action. Linking you in. You might feel a little discomfort at first. Blurred vision, low contrast, glitches. Well, how's it look? Feel all right to you?
Seen more dramatic improvements before.
Patience, kid. Give it a minute. Time for the scanner.
It might take you a few seconds to adjust, but first time's rarely the charm.
With anything, really. Scanner should eventually sync with your thought processes and read your intentions. I also injected an NCPD file search. Run into any ne'er-do-wells? You know exactly what they ne'er did well. It ought to work like a charm. Now draw your weapon. You should see your ammo count in a brand new sight.
How about the neurovirus? From the last job, can you check it?
Done and gone while we were putting in your implant. And a full sweep on your soft and circuits. Zap the critter. You're certified bug-free.
Shit, Victor, not bad. I don't know what to say.
Say you'll take this and remember the dosage. Two whiffs now, and another two in an hour.
What am I looking at?
A mild stim. Should boost neurotransmission in the short term and muffle some of the side effects while the implant takes.
You're the best, Vic. I owe you.
Go on, kid. Show them what you're made of. And once you hit the big leagues, get where you came from.
Babe, I can release it for you, but you'd have to watch out for negative energy fields and avoid.
Whoa now!
I can release it for you, but you'd have to watch out for negative energy fields and avoid mean reds.
V, yo, listen up. I talked to Dex while you were in with the doc. He's waiting in his ride for you. Ain't but a hop to where he's parked, next to Gramsci Burgers.
Okay, do my best to talk us up.
V, listen. I've got this delicate matter. That's why I called you. The number of cyber-psycho attacks in the city is on the rise. Now, that's probably not news to you, but this issue matters to me, for a few reasons. There are people who say cyberpsychosis can be treated.
Right.
And I know exactly how that sounds, but I believe even an unproven therapy is still better than a bullet to the brain. If I get a tip about a possible attack, I'll give you a call. Maybe you can investigate before MaxTac hits the scene. But remember, you're not there to execute anybody. Try to incapacitate the attacker, and I'll send someone to pick him up. I hope that's all clear.
Yo, Miss V. A pleasure.
Dexter Deshawn in the flesh. Ample indeed.
Let's roll. Mind if I ask you something right off the bangle? Would you rather live in peace as Miss Nobody, die ripe, old, and smelling slightly of urine, or go down for all times in a blaze of glory smelling near like posies without seeing your 30th?
This some sort of test?
Just a pet topic of mine.
I mean, riddles?
No, Miss V. Ontology. All right, listen close. Scanning a serious job now. Plain gargantuan compared to smashing up a scav home.
Hang on, got a question of my own now. Why all this, Dex? Why me? Could have had Jackie or T-Bug sitting here. Could have just done this on comms.
Call me old-fashioned, but I like to look anyone I do biz with in the eye. Had the pleasure of meeting the Jackster in the past, and sweet T-Bug helped this brother out 2 years ago. So here we are. Besides all that, got a special little pre-mission just for you. But we'll get to that.
Let me hear it. What's the job?
There's this prototype tech. A biochip, to be precise. Job's to grab it. Simple.
Guessing it belongs to a corp?
Arasaka. Surely that's no problem.
No problem. Just a death sentence. NC's Arasaka's turf. Nobody fucks with them here.
What can I say, Miss V? High risk, high reward. First rule of the afterlife. Besides that, I'm no leadhead. Ain't gonna leave no trace for them to follow, because we're gonna do this clean and on the hush-hush. We understand each other.
You work this out? Got a plan?
Two things. First, a conundrum with the Maelstrom boys. Needs active resolving, then. Second, a rendezvous. Simple. Client who brought us the job's anxious. She wants to parlay with one of the team.
Client. What's her thing? Why she need to meet?
Woman's name's Evelyn Parker. Vetting her wasn't easy. Put the word out I was looking for any kind of intel.
Right, and?
Some brothers from Pacifica got back to me. Told me to stop looking. End of convo. Anyway, our little client insisted on meeting someone with skin in the game. You know, who'll be there for it all. Yours truly will be remote. T-Bug ain't no people person, and Jaggy's only good at some things. I know you know what I mean. pretty much leaves you.
What's the issue needs resolving with Maelstrom? Got a beef?
Slot in the shard. Got a classic tale for you. Psycho gang doing its thing 2 weeks back. Jumped a Militech convoy. Got away with the gear. Corp don't even know Maelstrom's involved. Now see, convoy was carrying the Flathead, a little combat bot, a prototype. And I need me that bit of high-grade military tech. Because if we don't get that bot, we don't get no socket chip. And we sure as hell don't get no happily ever after. But don't get excited. It's a single-use toy. Now, I flat-out purchased the damn thing from Maelstrom. Problem is, I did so from a gent went by the name of Brick. I say when, because Brick was the leader. 3 days after we'd sealed our deal, his friend and gangmate, one Simon Randall, a.k.a. Royce, plain dropped his ass. Royce is in charge now, and I got no way of knowing if he aims to honor his predecessor's word. To add to this shitstorm, one Meredith Stout of Militech has developed an interest in said convoy.
Royce guy. What's he like?
A straight psychopath. Chrome-loving kind.
Big club in this town.
I'll give you that. Except few of its other members. No matter the stakes, would put a friend and associate through an industrial microwave dryer. Apparently, first thing to burst are the eyeballs. Get a nice clear pop. Then the rest goes goulash.
Who's the prima donna?
Corpo agent, internal affairs. Been skidding around town asking after the convoy as if her life depended on finding it. The one lead she's got zip tied in her trunk. Stick up her ass ain't growing any shorter. So she must be getting desperate. Be wise to think how you could use that. Of course, to do so, you'll need that frazzled cat's info. Sending it now. Miss V? Miss V?
Think I got everything. Time I got to work.
Well, that's just music to my ears. I'll set up the meet with Miss Parker at Lizzie's bar. Flathead, though, is gonna be all you. One more thing, Miss V. Quiet life or blaze of glory? Later now.
Jaxter, talk to Dex.
Yeah, Cortito's a big deal. Literally a nag, yeah.
Guy certainly knows how to protect his biz. Wants to put us on a few small kinks. Prep work, I guess. Before lining us up a big job. There's this combat bot military prototype. Maelstrom clept it. Then Dex paid to take it off their hands just before the gang goons had a switch up in management.
Right, heard about that. Royce versus Brick.
What do I say?
Hostile takeover.
That sums it up. Dex wants us talking to Royce. Gave the deeds of some Militech agent, too, but don't know how much help she stands to be.
Chingon.
Yeah, you don't sound thrilled. Royce, what do you know about him?
He's fucking whack something special. Junkie snort junk. Royce. Snorts chrome.
Then there's the other thing. Gotta meet the client who put the job on the table, Evelyn Parker.
You? Well, what's Dex gonna do? Ride around in his limo, chat chicks up on the hollow?
Parker wants to meet someone on the crew. Dex gave me the nod.
He must know what he's doing. So, how you want to play this? Maelstrom or Parker? What's first? Chica.
Parker. Think I ought to see her first. See what she's like, what she's after.
Orale. In that case, I'll hit the all foods. Put my nose to the ground. Hasta luego.
You want to hurry or something?
How do you see the time in the game?
I haven't figured that one out yet. If you go into your character and then you press escape where it gives you crafting inventory map character journal bottom left it shows you time.
Oh, and you can just skip time as well.
Yeah.
Hey there, dollface. Interest you in a preem BD?
What do you got?
What don't we got? Women and men of your dreams. Synaptic acting A-listers, no washed-up virtue porn boy toys or blow-up dolls here.
Auteur stuff. It'll grip your heart and blow your nerves right out of your body. Pure bit-based ecstasy. That's why people come here.
Clearly know how to sell it.
Not a sales pitch, it's a warning. I'll give you one word. Bespoke. Not for everyone's synapses.
Think you can handle it?
Bespoke? Damn, that sounds promising. I get it, I'm in.
Mm-hmm. Couple of things you need to know first. Severe penalties for any unauthorized recording. No drugs, no groping.
Someone catch your eye? You do not grab them. You find them in the catalog, ask for a BD, and get yourself a box.
I really look that green to you? Like I don't know?
Mm-hmm. Door's open. Have fun.
My, what a sweet
welcome to Lizzie's
face you have.
Hey.
Get you something.
What's on the menu? Looking for Evelyn Parker. Know if she's here?
Who's asking?
Just answer the damn question.
Seem a little tense, Chumba. Go grab a box. Might take the edge off. Have fun, relax. Find me once your mood's improved. Serve you a drink then.
It's all right, Mateo. Just wait for this. Evelyn Parker. I knew it was you as soon as you walked in. Sense on. Only tequila I drink. How would you know?
I like to know everything about the people I work with. Either that or it was just a lucky guess.
Why we meeting here? Any particular reason? Actually, it doesn't seem much like your thing, this place.
Mm-hmm. I'll take that as a compliment. Come on. No place we can talk where ears won't prick up to listen.
We'll be in the lounge, Mateo. Anyone asks, we're not here. So, what can
nothing's wrong.
Horny girl
really?
Like me do? Why don't you just tell me the truth?
I just told you.
Dex had a load to say about you. Called you professional, effective, and trustworthy. I hope he wasn't overselling. I'm good at what I do. Got a solid crew at my back, too. Never once botched a job.
You do realize I expect more of you than scraping street corner data terms. Much more.
I'm the best, and I know what I'm getting into. Dex was clear. The job's high risk.
By the way, you work together long? You and Dex?
Just started working with him, in fact.
I've heard there are two kinds of fixers. Those with stable crews on long contracts and short leashes. Loyalty and predictability they value above all else. Then there's the other kind. Dex's kind.
Come on. Can't leave that hanging.
Headhunters. They lay their trust elsewhere, not in people, but in a thing. Their intuition. They bet on potential. And if they lose that bet, it's the last mistake they ever make. I'm hoping Dex's intuition has served him well in this case.
Let's cut to the chase. What do you got for me?
Your target. I trust you know what it is.
Relic. Secure your soul trinket. Key tech in the program, actually. We're tangling with Arasaka. Making this heist one dangerous, risky motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Arasaka's poured billions into personality transfer technology. But me, I just want the data on this one. The chip is tucked away inside Compeki Plaza, the hotel. You ever been?
you know? Just never rolled through that neighborhood.
Damn shame. The fresh they serve is sinfully good. Chef must have made a deal with the devil.
So where's this chip hiding, exactly?
In a suite on the top floor. The room's occupied by Yorinobu Arasaka.
Yorinobu Arasaka? He's in town?
Don't you read the scream sheets? The media couldn't get enough of Yori coming to Night City. It was all over the headlines. Anyway, he's heir apparent to the Arasaka Empire. Saburo Arasaka's only surviving son.
What, so Arasaka Jr.'s planning to grab the reins while in Night City?
Only a handful of people in Night City know what the Arasaka's real plans are.
Telling me you're one of them? So we're not jumping the corp. We're jumping Yorinobu Arasaka himself.
Yorinobu is a puppet. He lost all his cards years ago when he failed to do Daddy's bidding. Saburo's had Yuri's balls in a vice for years. He might just turn the screw and crush them outright if he learns his son's up to no good again.
Top dog like Yorinobu is bound to have an army on call. Hotel's probably a goddamn fortress by now, too.
Yorinobu keeps exactly no hustle around. Not one guard. Got rid of them a long time ago.
Huh. Why is that?
Surely you know what they say about Arasaka Into. Sneeze in Night City, and a blossom drops from a cherry tree in Tokyo. Yorinobu was convinced his Arasaka security detail reported directly to his father.
Look, if you've got any spare aces up your sleeve, now's the time to show them.
Now this should make your tits perk up. Yorinobu recently swiped the chip from an Arasaka laboratory. He's made a deal with Netwatch, aims to sell it to them. Have you spotted my ace yet, or do I need to spell things out?
Wait, neutral Netwatch is mixed up in this?
Netwatch provides net security for all corporations, and collects eddies in the millions for it. But, in this day and age, everyone's in the game, and no one can afford to be a saint. To win, one has to go all in.
So what's Yorinobu do to walk away with?
Unimportant. You focus on the biochip.
What could cyberspace's watchers and protectors offer him? Intelligence on his enemies?
That doesn't matter in the least. Because you'll make sure the transaction never happens, and I get the chip. V?
Sounds like a good plan.
Right, this is going. I just picked up so much shit, I had to start disassembling.
Fine. So no Arasaka security on the device, because Yorinobu whisked it away in secret. Now where's he hiding it?
Likely in a specialized container. One that mimics an organic neural environment. On the outside, it looks like an ordinary briefcase.
And the case is?
You'll see for yourself soon enough. Provided we're done gossiping about the Arasakas.
One more thing. Data that's on the chip. What is it?
Irrelevant. Entirely.
We're talking about data Yorinobu snuck out of Arasaka. What's more, he wants to pass it on to Netwatch. Sounds pretty damn relevant to me.
Listen, V. The relic. That's my concern. Your concern? Earning a paycheck. Just get the job done. I'll make sure your bank accounts are sated.
What else do you know about Yorinobu?
Quite a bit, actually. He studied finance and biotech in Tokyo. Probably didn't have a choice in the matter, come to think of it. Saburo was grooming him to be his successor. But then Yorinobu vanished to chase his own dreams. Cut himself off from the corp for years. Long story short, though the black sheep returned, the bitter taste remained. But that's only one side of him. There's another. An intelligent man who has always walked his own path, and so has his own designs on the corp.
Could be another power-hungry corpo, Dick, like so many others.
Ever tried to imagine what life might be like for an emperor's son? You have everything, yet you are no one. Nothing. At least as long as you remain in Saburo Arasaka's shadow. I sympathize. It's a vulnerability I understand well.
And one you plan to exploit fully.
I'm waiting.
Okay, what's next?
Now comes the best part. Follow me.
Got something for you. Should help you plan. Brain dance from Compeki Plaza.
How's a brain dance supposed to help? Need facts, not thrills.
Think BDs are only good for fondling virtual tits? Jacking off to in those boxes? No. It can be a very useful tool.
You got this, dog.
Good for analyzing details, human perception, even boosted, doesn't grasp exactly what you need.
So what's on the tape?
Yorinobu's suite. The glorious interior. You'll need to locate the relic yourself. Hope I grabbed enough detail to make that possible.
Hold up. Mean to say you recorded this?
Mm-hmm. BD Rec implant. Why, you object?
No, not at all. Let's see this brain dance.
Judy'll help. She's a Mox, too. Besides, we go back, years. V, this is important. Judy's always been there for me. Always helped out. I trust her. But she's a Mox, not the latest member of your crew. Try not to forget. So you'll be a good girl, tread lightly, and keep that tongue on a leash.
Relax. Believe it or not, I'm no stranger to tact. In biz or life.
Hey, there you are.
This is V. She's here for that BD role. And V, this is Judy. Best brain dance editor I know.
Enough already.
Sensory SIG amps, acoustic and emotive wave monitors. Oh, top shelf hardware.
Yeah, most of it's customized. Only thing factory are the casings.
Mod all this yourself?
What do you think?
Expression translator. Fuyutsuki, right? Thought the matrices on that series were fucked up.
They were, but swapping out matrices is simple. And this was the only model that'd support additional scanware.
All right, all right.
Compiled your BDF.
What do you think? Will it do?
Still pretty raw, but yeah, ought to do.
Mm-hmm. V needs to get deep inside. That's most important.
So, let's calibrate. Tune it to her. Believe me, I've dealt with worse. Should see the jig-jig street porn we gotta contend with sometimes.
So, we drop V inside? Let her look, let her rummage around, right?
How about it, V? Raw brain dance. Ever taken a dip before?
What do you mean by raw? How's this differ from the ready-mades?
Huh. Ready-mades, provided they're well-made, should feed you feelings and impressions you'd never have the chance to experience yourself in real space. But it's mass-market shit, so it's pre-crafted, hard-coded, fenced-in, and manageable. A raw one? Well, it's more like a virtue enviro. Get to move around, look at things in detail. Editors use those layers to fish for juicier emotes and impulses, then use them to pad the BDs that go to market. Sit down, settle in, and we'll get you going. Create your sensory profile first.
A what profile now?
A model of your perceptions and emotional responses. Need to adjust that so the raw BD won't overwhelm you. If I don't, best case scenario, you'll get nauseous as soon as you're in. Probably barf like you would in a shoddy virtue environment.
Mm-hmm. And worst case?
Your synapses sizzle like locusts in a deep fryer. But we're not about to let that happen.
Okay, hit me. Just promise me it won't hurt.
It won't. Not this time. Now sit still, look at me. Gonna run the analysis soft. Should feel a slight tingling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now let's set the optics and other sensory sigs. Look smack into these two screens. Pretend it's an eye exam.
Get a lot of requests like this?
All the time. But it's usually stuff the girls scroll at the club. I take that and do some routine porn tuning.
Crank up the orgasms?
More like, cut out all the other shit. Fucking's business as usual for these guys. Their minds wander to grocery lists, spouses' birthdays, late bills, whatever. But even then, you can refigure things. Mold the emotions into something unique, unforgettable. Can't complain. One more sec. Need to get the pain receptor limiters in. Okay. All set. You need to test your profile first. Tossing in a sample BD. You can use it to get to know the editor. Now let me see. Where could we...
Can't you just use my recording? Why are we wasting time?
So we don't risk our necks? Besides, won't take a sec. Got something here. Should be perfect.
What'd you choose?
Corner store hold up in Haywood. Real amateurs. Don't even know where I got it. Suits our needs perfectly, though. You ready?
Boot it up.
Mm-hmm. Let me give you the tailored version first. Let you get your bearings. Then we'll jump into editing. Be diving in 3, 2, 1.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
And remember, everything on full blast. They'll spot us extra for a wicked adrenaline high. Okay, on you go.
Everybody! On the ground! I want to see you kissing the flooring! Money! Now! Or I will fucking drop you, I swear to God! Whoa! Yeah! Hey! Now! Before I blow your fucking head off!
Ah! Slow, deep breaths. Your cortisol and adrenaline spiked, but the soft activated your hormone blockers. Nothing happened. You're alive and well.
A flash of intense shock. I can still feel it. I remember. Fuck. That last second. Could it warn me how much it hurts to die?
Trust me, real death hurts much, much more.
Not so sure about that.
You'll be fine. Got everything set up. Let's switch over to editing mode. I'll sever the link to the BD roller's sensory array. You'll be able to look around freely. Whole scene's yours.
Full cam control and analysis mode, so move around, zoom in and out, whatever else you come up with. Think of it as your own little sandbox. So, analysis mode, you control playback. Can even pause when you feel the need. Then you use the editor console to unpause.
You go in, snatch the cash, get out, and we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
Dream as hell, right? Well, that's not all. You can speed things up or rewind, whatever you like. Give it a try. Rewind. Roll it back to the top. All good. Neat. Now try fast forwarding a bit.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't be creative. You go in, snatch the cash.
Okay. You can also reset the recording. That'll take you right back to the beginning. Try it. Now for some fun. This here's why you came in the first place. In analysis mode, you get to view and even scan details of the enviro recorded by the BD roller. Focus on the heat, the gun this gonk gets from his buddy at the beginning. Now scan it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't create it. You don't need to send BD to those psycho freaks from the studio. And with everything on full.
Yo! Find yourself. No, I've been playing Cyberpunk actually. What are you thinking? Yeah, Burger King sounds good, dude. Okay. Sweet, check it just now. Bye.
They'll spawn extra for a wicked adrenaline high.
Nothing like that around where I am.
On you go.
Okay, right here. Excellent. Let's move on. Now heads up. In analysis mode, you can ferret out background noise and conversations if the roller got close enough. This tech records everything, every little detail, even the sights and sounds the roller was never aware of. To see the sources of the recorded sensory signals, switch to the audio layer in the editor. Go ahead and try that now. Okay, good. Now you should see several sound signatures in the store. Choose one and hone in on it.
Seriously, like it was happening right next to me.
Yeah, it's how BD recording implants work. They pick up everything, all the elements in the background. Then an editor tweaks them, makes them pop. Keep playing with the sound, explore it a bit. We'll move on when you get bored.
On the ground! What a circus in the flooring! Money! Now, or I will fucking drop you, I swear to God! Whoa! Yeah, hey! Now! Before I blow your fucking head off!
Limits of the reality recorded by the BD roller. The editor won't let you outside it. Make sense? Sometimes you can analyze extra layers in the raw, stuff the roller's cyberware picked up.
Like what?
Ev's got Kuroshi optics that grab infrared. Meaning you should be able to grab heat signatures from her recording.
Huh. Hella nice.
Now let's wait till the guy punches out the gonk at the counter. Scanning works on peeps, too. Walk up to the wounded chick. Try scanning her. All right, next thing. Scroll forward to the part where our artist gets a lead injection.
Now, where I will fucking drop you, I swear to God! Whoa! Yeah! Hey!
Oh, man. Fuck's sake. I kept on fucking... I'm doing the video thing.
Now! Before I blow your fucking head off!
The video thing.
See that?
You know there's a built-in streaming thing on in the game.
But you
oh, really?
Here it comes.
Yeah, what it does is... It'll cut out
the music, yes.
Yeah, copyrighted stuff and replaces it with stuff that's good.
Cam feeds to the screen behind the clerk. Roll back to where the screen's in the kid's field of vision, then scan it.
I think he's on mute, maybe.
No, but it's not only the music, it's also the new key and all of that stuff.
What's up, boys?
How much?
Are you ready?
His own tomb.
Can you get on with the stream, please? Probably planned to all along. Nobody yeah. told me this is adult
nice
stream.
Slice of cred on the black market for a BD like this.
Oh, am I?
BD freaks are ready to pay a preem for a real flatline. Anyway, if you've seen enough, you can exit.
Coming
impressive,
from
right?
YouTube,
too bad most of the BDs we do here are only good
Discord.
For flogging the log. Anyway, you ready to do this? Look at your wreck?
I don't know. Let's take a break. Still feel like that kid when... Yeah. Think I'm done.
V, there's no time.
Hello?
Yeah, get it together, please.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Go ahead. Just need T-Buck to link in.
Whoa, who?
Runner for my crew, security specialist. She'll tell me what to look for while we analyze. No problem, I hope.
Actually, it is a problem. Not what we agreed, Ev. Judy, please. Ev, she wants to bring a runner in. What part of that don't you understand? How do I know she'll only slip into this footage? Me. I'm your guarantee.
Yeah, right.
Remember our agreement? Help me this one last time. I promise everything will work out, just like we planned. Okay, V. Call T-Bug and we'll dive in.
Oh no, it's not an issue. I was quite confused for a second.
Hey V, what's happening?
Bug, why listen, is your mind
I got
so
some useful
now?
Footage from Konpeki Plaza. It's a brain dance.
Konpeki?
Softer than usual, I listen to my setting. Let me have a look.
Someone there with you?
The voice, what's the name?
Okay. Okay. Okay, cool.
Judy and Evelyn, they're chill. They're helping me work.
So you enjoying it, bruv?
Uh-huh. Alright. You gonna tell me what this is about?
Listen,
hi, dog.
Need your help. Got no clue what to look for once I'm in.
All right, see if I can walk you through it. Jacking into your tech now. You've got to give me access. Opening port 1779. Secure protocol? Good, I'm going in. Should be getting my request now.
Got it. You ready?
A millisec. Okay, connection confirmed. Now some quick tip ice and we're clear. Ready to dance.
Fire her up, Judy.
All right, V, eyes open. Gotta find out where Yurinobu's keeping the relic.
You live like a cut of fuckable meat, are you? I said
Then you shall perish for a good cause.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute.
Listen in on that conversation, V. Could be something important.
Finish. We shall see, Sasha. I said no.
They'll have my head for this.
Then you shall perish for a good cause.
Here in a drone, ventilation and cooling? Servers, gotta be. Fancy doodads in here need to be controlled.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to finish. We shall see soon enough. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with your father. He's taken a particular interest in this project. He can certainly explain the risks.
My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change, and he'll live forever in his tiny, frozen bubble.
I should not even be listening to such things.
You will listen to this. Saburoi is an adult despot, utterly removed from reality. Stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists. Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years. I am quite sure we want now.
Read the documentation carefully. The relic requires specific storage conditions. You must provide them.
Heard that? Relic docks gotta be around here somewhere. Look for them.
Sorry to make you wait. Business can be stupid.
That's awkward.
It will pass.
I can get to work on that. Just one condition.
You wish to make demands of me?
Only one. Focus on me. Oh, got any candy left? Steph was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom. Nightstand.
I've got an idea.
I'm here already.
Just a sec. For the perfect thing. Ah, you'll like this.
What love is until you've learned the meaning of it. Until you've loved the love of us. No. Until you've learned the meaning.
Manual details a special temp-controlled container. Relic needs to be kept real cool.
So Chip's gotta stay in the freezer.
Yep, could damage it otherwise. Okay, switch on thermal layer detection in the editor. Should be easier to spot where your Nobu's keeping the chip.
Yeah, hold it.
Rich, I'm coming back now, brother.
Looks like Mr. Arasaka had something to celebrate. Really think you'll find the chip in there? No way. Temp's too low. Could fluctuate. Nice try, though. Just a fancy-ass fridge. Temp doesn't match the guidelines. Won't find a thing here.
Visionless old gray beard. But it's nothing changed, and he'll live forever.
Just one condition.
You. Nothing will change, and he'll live forever in his tiny frozen bubble.
I should not even be listening to such things.
You will listen to this.
The meaning of a dream. Until you've lost the love you've had. And the love.
Warui kome. I miss this.
It hurts, but it means...
some f-
Quest where you have to find the little CPU or chip or whatever it is. Okay. Lou's just done this.
Alarm firmware's fresh, but saw excited birds chirping on a BBS. Something about lots of seeds falling to this sieve. Let me generate keys. I can forge their six.
You shall perish for a good cause.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with your father. He's taken a particular interest in this project. He can certainly explain the risks.
My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change and he'll live forever in his tiny frozen bubble.
Sir? You say something, Richard.
Okay, boys, I'm gonna hop over into the Tarkov channel. Chat you guys later.
Cool, catch you later.
Listen, in this, I found the... So, scan the apartment security systems as an option.
So are you in the brain rot?
Yes.
Stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists. Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye.
Alarm to the left, there's a camera to the right.
I'm quite sure we want now.
Read the documentation carefully.
Basically, when you're in visual mode, in editor mode, and then you're in visual mode by pressing shift to change the visual. You play the brain dance until the marker is over a yellow bar. If it's over a yellow bar, it means there's something for you to scan, because if there's nothing for you to scan, there won't be anything on that bar. And if there is something and you scan it, and there's nothing else to scan, that bar disappears. You may need to play it backwards and forwards until you come across.
Shit, Kim's packed with new tech. Okay. Motion sensors, heat sink activators, IFF.
You skilled enough to kill it all?
Evening, sir.
Mucho more than enough.
Evening.
Just need access to their subnet.
How's the report?
We shall see soon enough.
All good.
Good. How's your experience been so far?
Right. Grab the heat sink. Matches the spec in the docks.
I'll be there soon.
Yorinobu's got the case here. Guaranteed.
Thoroughly impressed.
Mm-hmm. We got it. Good work. Looks like we got everything we need. Quit out of the editor.
Richard says the gas a bit shut.
With your father. He's taking a particular interest in this project.
Oh dear.
I'm just kidding.
That may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for past
years. Beauty, now.
Step whisper.
So are you in audio now?
No.
Automated turrets. Latest scanner model. Systems all connected to the server.
Can you shut them off?
Externally? No way. Gotta get in, check out how they link into the system first. Mm-hmm. Looks like all their security systems are linked to the hotel subnet. We need the flathead. No other way to shut down these systems.
Can't get around them ourselves?
Nope. At least I'm fresh out of ideas.
Pretty fun last time. Like this.
Loaded. Safety's on. Good to know, though. Once you're in there, don't forget about that iron.
If you're stuck, you might need to stream, Richard, so I can see what you're doing.
Air conditioning, standard model for hotels of this caliber.
Get everything you need?
Yep, that'll do. Thanks, Judy. We got it. Later, T-Bug.
Nice work today. See you soon.
I'll wipe the cache on your data. You were never here.
Keep it. I'll put it on Ev's tab. Portable device for handling BDs. I already uploaded your calibration settings.
Not as sophisticated as what we got here, but should do the trick. And it keeps you out of harm's way. Clever. Speaking of harm's way, know what I see looking at you? Walking, talking corpses.
Cool, I'm gonna jump channels. I'll see you guys in stuff.
Yeah.
Relax. I got it all under control.
If you fuck up and they come knocking on my door, Judy, relax. That's not gonna happen. Evelyn, please. No shortcuts. You go that route, City'll always win. So be careful.
Of course I will be. Besides, we'll talk in a bit. Let's walk. Well, what do you think?
Intel on Yorinobu, the chip, the BD from Konpeki. Winds are right, plan's perfect. A job like this comes one in a million.
Hmm, thanks. Now the punchline, please.
Just sounds too good to be true. What's the catch?
Cold feet. Are you looking to get out of it?
I want to know if you're really in control.
V, I have zero reasons to haze you. We're in this together. Really. Trust me that I got this.
You're not worried? Arasaka will flag and screen anyone who's had dealings with Yorinobu.
Oh, they'll have a long list then. Packed full of big names. Much bigger than mine. You tell me who they check first. Corpo hotshots and cutthroats? Or a little bedroom plaything like me?
Think I see how you know so much about Yorinobu.
It's simple. Men like pillow talk a bit too much.
So it's just about the sex?
Biz. And biz only.
So? What now?
V. Do this job for me. I mean me alone. No splitting the payout with anyone else. No middlemen. No Dex.
No fucking way. Dex took a leap with me. He trusts me.
Now I'm doing the same. 50%. With cred like that in your account, you won't need Dex for anything.
No, Evelyn, it's not just about the money.
I thought you were a merc. I thought it was always about the money.
Not behind the back of someone who trusts me. Sorry.
Fine. I never asked. But V?
Hmm.
I just hope you're as good as you are naive. If you need me, call. I'll send you my number.
Okay.
Good luck. Now go. I need a few words with Judy.
How things looking, Miss V?
What? It's hard to say.
Turns out Evelyn's recording from Konpeki was worth our time.
All right.
Beautiful. T-Bug already called. Said she's working her magic. And the flathead?
Nothing yet. On it now.
T-Bug says no chance at that chip without that buy. To work then, Miss V.
Yeah.
I'm off the clock, hon.
The next time you fuck something up.
Yeah? Money. Tell the girls at the door. They will take care of you.
No. It's my friend.
My? What a sweet little face you have.
I know.
Going in?